Here we have a distillation column. So here's our distillation column. And the feed to the distillation column, which is right here, is 45 mole percent N-pentane and 55 mole percent N-hexane. And it is a liquid. The vapor stream leaving the column, which contains 98 mole percent of the pentane and the balanced hexane, goes to a total condenser. So this vapor stream goes to a total condenser. Half of the liquid condensate is returned to the column, and the rest is withdrawn as a product at a rate of 85 kilomoles per hour. The overhead product contains 95% of the pentane fed to the column. The liquid stream leaving the bottom of the column, is right here, goes to a reboiler. Part of the stream is vaporized and recycled to the bottom of the column, and the liquid is taken off as a product as well. So let's label what we know. Both of these are 85 kilomoles per hour, which means this is 170 kilomoles per hour. This is some N sub L, and this is some N sub vapor. And we know that this stream is 98% pentane and 0.02 hexane. Why do we put that in, even though a composition of the vapor stream leaving the column? Well, when it totally condenses, you're not going to change any of the mole fractions. So whatever it came in at, it's going to come out at. So here we have some X sub P, which is the mole fraction in the liquid of the pentane, and 1 minus X sub P. And here we have a Y sub P and 1 minus Y sub P, where those are the mole fractions in the liquid and in the vapor, respectively. So one of the things that we're told is that the overhead product contains, and we'll call this N sub 1, overhead product contains 95% of the pentane fed to the column. So our overhead product, which is 85 kilomoles per hour, the amount of pentane in that is 98% of it, and that's going to equal 95% of the pentane, which is 0.45 times 9.1, fed to the column. So that piece of information allows us to solve for our N1, which is 195 kilomoles per hour. That's the molar flow rate of the feed stream. Now the molar flow rate and composition of the bottom liquid stream, we can do an overall balance to find N sub L. So 195 equals 85 plus N sub L. Remember, when you're doing an overall balance, you don't include the streams that are not part of what's going in and out of the process. We only have three streams, N1, 85 kilomoles per hour, and NL, that are in or out of the process. So now we have the molar flow rate of the bottom liquid stream, and that equals 110 kilomoles per hour. To find the X sub P, we could either do a pentane balance or a hexane balance, but let's do a pentane balance since we have X sub P there. So 0.45 times N1, which is 195 kilomoles per hour, equals 0.98 times 85 kilomoles per hour. That's what's leaving up at the top, plus our X sub P times our N sub L, which is 110 kilomoles per hour. And when we solve for X sub P, we find that it's 0.0405. The next thing that we're asked to do is to find the temperature of the vapor as it enters the condenser, assuming it is saturated. As soon as you see that those words, it is saturated, it should tell you that you should be using Raoult's law at an absolute pressure of 1 atmosphere, and then we need to find the volumetric flow rates of the vapor leaving the column and the top liquid product. So let's start with the temperature of the vapor as it enters the condenser, and that's that 170 kmol. And again, it is in equilibrium because it is saturated. So what that means is that the Y sub P of the pentane times the total pressure equals the mole fraction in the liquid times the vapor pressure at that temperature, which is what we're trying to find. We set up the same relationship for toluene. So this is P star of toluene at the temperature. So we know that Y sub P equals 0.98. Y sub T equals 0.02. We also know, and this is how we're going to rewrite it, that X sub P plus X sub T equals 1. So now let's rewrite both of our equations in terms of our X's. So our X sub P is Y sub P times the total pressure over our vapor pressure at the temperature. So that's our X sub P that we got from here. And we add that to Y sub T times P times the vapor pressure of toluene at that temperature. And that we got from here. And that has to equal 1. So we write it as 0.98, that's our Y sub P, times 760 millimeters of mercury. That's our pressure, 1 atmosphere, divided by, now we have to write out the vapor pressure of pentane, 6.85221 minus 1064.63, again this is Antoine's equation, divided by T plus 232. So that's our first term, plus now we're going to look at the toluene, and these have to equal 1. And using some kind of solver or MathCAD or some program like that, we find that the temperature equals 37.3 degrees C. Now we're asked to find the volume or the volumetric flow rate of the stream that is coming out of the distillation column, this vapor stream that is 170 kmol per hour. So, because it's a vapor, we're going to assume the ideal gas law. So, V equals nRT over P, which is 170 kmol per hour, times 0.08206 meter cubed atmosphere per kilomole Kelvin, and our temperature that we just found, which is 310.5 K. divided by 1 atmosphere. However, our volumetric flow rate of the liquid product coming out, because it's a liquid, we can't use the ideal gas law. So instead, we have to use a combination of the density and the molecular weight. So let's start with our pentane. So that's 0.98 times 85 kilomoles per hour. And the molecular weight is 72.15 kilograms per kilomole. And now our density is 0.621 kilograms of pentane per 1 liter. So that's just the volumetric flow rate of the pentane. Now we have to do the same for the hexane, 0.02 times 85 kilomoles per hour. And again, we're going to have different molar masses or molecular weights, 86.17 kilogram per kilomole, and a different density, 0.659 kilograms of hexane per liter. And when we add this all together, our volumetric flow rate of the liquid product is 9.9 times 10 to the third liters per hour.